We have Lucy Semis, Dirty Dan versus Nate Senpai. We're going with Ness and the Diddy. Probably the two characters that I would associate with them the most.
This is a good matchup, actually. Both of them are really slippery, have a wide range of moves.
I'm not sure how this matchup has been going recently. I'm pretty sure that Nate was winning it when I left. Dirty Dan has definitely impressed me tonight. He's playing pretty well. Either he's having a really good night or he's just gotten better.
Oh. finally, sort of on camera.
A little bit. There he goes. He disappears again. This thing about Ness's recovery, it's really difficult to hit.
Oh,
the banana covering.
He's
covering
so
every
good.
Option.
He's so good hitting, getting the banana.
Yeah. I was going to say, Ness's up B, it's really hard to do, and it's really vulnerable and stuff, but if you hit it, it goes a long way. It came straight from the blast zone all the way back on the stage, and you beat the ledge. He hit the banana. I think that claims it for him. Like, it reflects it.
Oh, he did not know.
Yep, yep.
That's not your banana.
Nate with a very stylish little PK Thunder 2 ledge cancel and PK Fire also ledge cancel.
Oh, okay.
About 10 seconds ago. Showing off those moves. He didn't actually do anything, but style points are style points. You take them when you get them. There we go, a hitbox hit somebody. Oh, he goes for the yo-yo extension and does not get it.
Guess what we call to say that was a no-no. I'll be here.
Next got hit by one peanut, but he saved his upbeat until after he got hit so he was able to come back. Grab the ledge, put himself in a very bad situation for Dirty Dan to capitalize on. He's already at 105%, so Nate definitely got all the extra credit. Just get rid of the banana.
Get it out of here.
Projectile pressure there. Just let me get that easy curve.
He missed
the trip tech. Dirty Dan though. He has been destroying Nate on this stock. He was at, I think, 105, and I mean he's still living.
Nate's living, boys.
Absolutely in trip
tech. Ooh, wow.
Look at that, he slid on the ground for a second before blasting off. So, Dirty Dan needs to take this very quickly. Catches him with a weak hit of the down smash. It's charged pretty far, but he can't weak hit. And Dan gets the combo started. Dirty Dan actually manages to spot dodge out of it. Man almost catches him, makes an air dodge instead, and then takes a back air to the face.
Oh, gets him off stage.
Yep.
And not enough with the
flip of the up air. Banana comes out just a little bit too late. Just been maybe a second sooner, it would have actually caught him, or at least forced him the same direction. But yeah, that back air.
Boom! Dirty little kid on the screen.
Bringing it back.
One of the PRC matchups that we love seeing in the PRC. Nate versus Dirty Dan for a while.
The old Poopy Rat crew.
Yup. One of the best players in the PRC for a while. And then Edboy came in. Edboy's really good.
When he plays. And Dirty Dan.
Losing stock.
Decides he doesn't want to play the video game. Just kind of get out of there. I don't need that first stock. You can have it. And I'll take the second. Nate.
Oh, yeah, spaghetti.
So Nate kind of doing the same thing for himself. The difference is that Dirty Dan has 81% because of how early Dirty Dan decided to drop that first stock. The gentleman, the three, and Nasus is come back.
Wow.
The chain grabs. I didn't know that he had a chain grab, but apparently he does.
Ooh, the snipe was real.
Yeah. He gets under too real. And I mean, so Dirty Dan hit him out of it, but Nate was going to ledge cancel PK Thunder 2 on the Moogle Smash Bros. Platform. That is good. That takes down. A lot of practice went into that. Oh! He got scared because he knew he had to hit that PK Thunder 2, otherwise he was going to get knocked out of it, and it messed up his angle.
Wow, the extra damage. Nana hitting him while they're in the grab.
Yup. And despite the weirdness of the beginning, this is a very even game again. Two stocks, mild damage. Oh, he almost sniped. He was going for the PK Thunder 2. Or PK Thunder 1, rather. Not going for the S himself.
Boom! Sending him off.
Yeah. He was focused too much on placing the peanut. He knew how close he was to getting the PK Thunder. And that's actually just air dodge. And he was too far away and still shooting peanuts, wasn't able to capitalize. Multiple PK fires hitting. That can interrupt the upbeat. Not yet.
Oh, wow.
Excellent DI from Dirty Dan. Air dodge is away. That slick movement. Yeah, okay. That was good, yeah, as you can get.
I bit my tongue,
yeah,
like,
say, like, at that percentage, for Diddy Kong, he should probably die. Goes for the combo, slips into the banana peel, doesn't matter, picks it up anyways, goes for some crazy suns.
Now we got ourselves a game winner.
Going back to Smashville again. Look how close the game is then, that makes sense.
Well, BB once, shame on you. BB twice. Yep. There might be a problem.
With all the cops. I'm saying you're cheating. Call the Nintendo police out. Ooh! Forward tilt, lock forward, forward tilt. Grab ledge, down smash. Shot a peanut across the stage and just went.
From across the map, had. What is this? Modern Warfare 2?
Almost said. It would have been hilarious had it.
Ooh, okay.
Three man going in.
Commentator's curse? No, not that. In my heart.
Alright, okay. Oh, here
we're
we
going
go again.
Back to Smashville. Beat me once, shame on me. Beat me once and also let me kill myself once. Also shame on me, but apparently still my volume stops. Okay, pretty damn going pretty far down. May not even grab the ledge. With the PK fire, but it's been able to hit the ball up. Great Dan kind of DI'd out of that. Catches the back air though. Catches the speed outside. Great Dan needs to go back up without taking any damage, so he's stopping you. Definitely seen from this set is that no lead is really safe.
Yeah, like we've seen Nate bring it back, we've seen Dirty Dan bring it back.
In fact, it's almost like having a lead
is a disadvantage. One stock is not a lead, as they say. One stock is actually a disadvantage. That's what they say. Come back to the real. It's a lot harder for him to snipe than on how he can let him go. He's actually hit him once or twice, but it doesn't interrupt him.
Yeah, he has to get the little wall.
Yeah, he has, however, gotten some mileage off of his peanuts before he gets the jack. And that's probably how he's going to get the main wildly multiple ledge.
Daniel Grubb looks to get this kill really early, as soon as possible, not trying to get as much damage, but,
He's a bit of a combo for Nate. A little bit more of a combo.
Oh.
This is definitely the point where you go mid deeper than you normally would, because if you're able to get that kill, great. If not, well, it's not that big of a advantage. Like I said, just dive right there. And GI notwithstanding, Nugent did dive from that back here. One good combo in the result of Nugent will take the stock. Do it quickly before Nate. It's completely way free. Go nuts. He pops the blue with the banana pull, not even the throw. Throw goes.
Ooh, okay.
Alright, 45% plus stage control for banana. Yeah, this is relatively even. Of course, Nate, this is winner stock.
Oh.
Yeah, went a little bit a little bit too far. That change grab's not Nate. Got dodged out of it. Gets a percentage off of that. Slide over. It really is just a couple inches. It goes just a little bit too far.
So we got a game on our hands, boys.
Yep. Last stock, last hit. Both up over 100%. Nate, the back row, mid stage, not quite going to do it. 150%. He goes a little bit fancy with the game on two, and then actually needs to get out of it. Puts him off stage. Back here.
Woo.
Platform there to save.
Another
back there,
it is right there.
Nerdy Dan takes loser semi. Diddy Kong.